What is up? Flutter Mentor here, and today we're going to get very specific. We're going to make this image animate into an app bar as you scroll down. This is usually for product pictures. I decided to use a meme so it would be funnier. And I didn't want to write a bunch of imaginary copy to sell the imaginary product, so I just did this container that says, scroll me, homie. Right now, if I do this, it's just scrolls. It's pretty boring. And we're going to turn that into this animation right here, which is much smoother, as you can see. It fades into the app bar and it just looks so much better. And by the way, if this was part of a stack and you had the option to go back a page, the back arrow would show up right here. And that's about it. Cue the intro. So what we have here is just an image and a container. That's pretty much it. Everything else will be removed, so just focus on those two. And the first thing I'm going to do is comment out the app bar because it's not going to be necessary. And now I'm going to remove the single child scroll view as well as the column. And instead of the column, we're going to use a custom scroll view widget, which does not have children. Instead, it has slivers. And this isn't the kind of slivers it likes, so let's take them out. I'm just going to do Control X, because I don't want to lose that data. And custom scroll view is basically for when you need more control over how scrolling is handled. Or if you want different things to happen when you scroll, much like the example we're about to do. Remember that what we want to do is smoothly transform the image into the app bar. And you may also be asking yourself, what are slivers exactly? Essentially, they're just scrollable areas on the screen. So if it's on the screen and it scrolls, guess what? It's a sliver. And what is it that this list of slivers really wants? Well, in this specific case, it wants a sliver app bar as well as a sliver list. And as you can see, you need to set a delegate for the sliver list. And the sliver list is a bit complicated to explain. I will leave the link to the documentation on the description if you want to check it out. But very basically, imagine this as a list view, but as a part of a screen with multiple scrollable parts. And so the sliver list needs a delegate that essentially tells it how to render the content of the list. Now, in our case, we're going to do SliverChildListDelegate, but if you have a long list of items that will need to be rendered, for performance sakes, much like the list view has the list view builder, here you should use sliver child builder delegate, but we're going to use the other one, the sliver child list delegate, because we just have one item, there's no point to it, and this expects a list as well. And this is pretty much where the content below the image goes. In our case, it's this without this part right here. And just imagine that you could have whatever you want here, like a column with a bunch of descriptions about the product you're displaying, etc. In our case, it's just this orange box that says, scroll me, homie. That's pretty much it. And now that this has been taken care of, we go on to the sliver app bar. I'm going to start by defining the content within it, which is through this property called flexible space, which takes a widget, which is going to be flexible spacebar. And within flexible spacebar, we will set the title, which is basically the text that will show on the app bar once it becomes an app bar. And before it is an app bar, it will be the text ahead of the image. For example, imagine we're selling this meme as an NFT. And here we would say, computer thumbs up NFT. And then you define the background, and the background is the image, like so. But there are a few more properties we can do, which is the pinned property, which is essentially if you want the app bar to always follow the scroll or not. I'll show you the difference between true and false. In fact, let me increase this. It'll probably help. I just increased the height of this container so it would scroll further. Let's start with the pinned app bar. And then the expanded height. This is an important part because if you have 10 different products or 20 or 30, whatever, I advise you to use images that have the exact same size. Otherwise, this will work well for some products. Others will be scaled poorly, etc. So just make sure all of your products would have the same image. And also here, use a media query, because if you don't, it'll be a mess once it changes devices. Dot of context, dot size, dot height. And for this image's size, I played around and I figured that doing this value right here would be what works best for an image of this size. And by the way, the image's dimensions are these right here. But that's about it. If I restart the app, you see that the container now takes up all of the width, but that's because the sliver child list delegate works differently from the column widget. But as you can see, imagine this would be a product image and it would be right here, computer thumbs up NFT. And let me just quickly change the font size because it's a bit too big. There you go. And now if I scroll, watch as it animates into an app bar very smoothly. As you can see, it fades into an app bar, and because the pinned here is true, the app bar follows along with the scrolling. If you want it to disappear, you just have to remove this because the default is false. Hit the save button, and now if I do it again, it does become an app bar, but then it disappears from the image. So it's up to you which one you prefer. Personally, I think pinned looks better, but that's just my personal opinion. So this is just one of those details that can make your app look better than the average app out there. And what I was talking about with the expanded hides, I do 0.5 instead and I save it. Look at the image. It does not look as good. The effect still works fine, but everything still works. If this was the effect you were looking for, you can still use it as well. Obviously, this looks better. It's really up to you. And just in case you're doubting if this would work across different devices, let me go ahead and show you that's not true. Hit the run on here and hit it on here as well. And essentially, this is the biggest one, the largest one sideways, then this is the second largest device, and this is the smallest one. And as you can see, it works everywhere. The animation works fine in all of them, here too. So as you can see, the media query can really come in clutch here and make sure it works across different devices. So just play around with the widget and see what you can discover it does. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please hit the like button. And of course, if you want to keep on learning Flutter, hit the subscribe button as well. It has been a pleasure. Thank you for watching. This is Flutter Mentor. And out.